Good morning, dear students. Today we will study bio. Okay, so in bio, as you know, that we were doing the chapter the body and its movement. So children, in the previous class of bio, we were talking about the movement of the body parts, how they move and how it is different from humans to different animals. Like the movement of animals are different from that of humans, isn't it? Like birds move differently, earthworm moves in a different way, cockroach moves in a different way, fish move and swim in a different way. Okay, so each and every living creature that has a capability to move apart from the plant, so they also have a different pattern of movement. Okay, so we are talking about that today. So basically, in this chapter, we will focus about humans' movement. Okay, hum kaise move karte hain? Jab hum chalte hain, to we walk with the help of legs. Okay, apart from walking from the legs, there are several body parts which are movable, isn't it? Like for example, we can move our head, we can rotate our head, isn't it? These jaws are moving. We can move our hand, we can move our shoulder. Okay, so there are several body parts that can move. Now the question is, how are we able to move? Aisa kya hota hai hamari body mein so that we are able to move? So it is the bones that are present in our body which allow us to move and rotate and like move the different parts of the body. Okay, and it is bone which helps our body structure to be stiff and straightened. It provides the framework to our body. Now imagine, agar hamari body mein bones na ho, to kya hoga? We will be just like a jelly, isn't it? Sirf muscles hongi, to hum sirf ek jelly ki tarah honge. Hamare body mein bilkul bone na ho. Bones ho hi na hamari body mein. So is it able to survive? No, we cannot survive. We cannot even stand properly. Okay, our body will not have any shape if bones are not present. Okay children, so what does bones do? Bones provide support and framework to the human body. Getting it? And it also allows to move the different parts of our body. Okay, so now children, this complete framework of the bone, that is starting from the skull, that is head to neck to all the rib cage, then the backbone and all the arms and legs bone, all the complete bone structure that are present in our body is combinedly called a skeleton. What are they called? They are called a skeleton. And if we are talking about humans, so it is called human skeleton. Clear children? It is called human skeleton. Okay, so quickly tell me, many of you must be knowing it. How many bones do we have in our body? How many bones do we have in our body? We have altogether 206 bones. How many bones? 206 bones. Okay? But children, when a child is, like when we were a child, very small, just we have taken a birth, to us time pe, we have more bones. Okay? Approximately to 300 bones. Hamari body mein jab a child birth leta hai and till few months, like till 6 months to 8 months, when a child is of 6 to 8 months, uski body mein 300 bones hoti hai, theek hai? But slowly and gradually, few bones start to fuse. Kuch bones kya hoti hai? Fuse hone lagti hai, aapas mein mix hone lagti hai. So as we become adult, so altogether we have 206 bones in our body. Clear? And all these 206 bones forms a human skeleton. Okay? So now in this chapter, we are going to talk about the various types of bones that are present in our body. Okay? So we will talk about the human skeleton. Okay? I think this topic is very interesting and you will find it very interesting to learn. Okay? Apne baare mein janna, it is good. Okay? So let's quickly start with the explanation of the topic, the human skeleton. Okay? So I'll show you the whiteboard. So ye kya hai beta? This is human skeleton. As you can see there above, this is human skeleton, isn't it? So this human skeleton is having different kinds of bones attached and different framework, isn't it? A head region, arms, legs, chest. So all these things are present inside our body. Okay, so in this chapter, children, we will be talking about each and every part of the bone differently. Okay, hum log separately ek ek part ko padhenge ki kya hota hai ye. Theek hai? Human skeleton ko basically kuch parts mein divide kiya gaya hai. That is, human skeleton is divided into few parts. That is, skull. Okay, skull, this is called a skull, the upper portion, the head region is called a skull. Then we have rib cage. So what is rib cage? This is a rib cage. This area is called a rib cage. This is a skull. This is rib cage. Okay, then we have backbone. So what is backbone? This is called backbone. This is a backbone. Okay. Then limbs. So if you talk about limbs, so in limbs we will see arms bone and legs bone. So this is the arm. So we'll talk about arm bone and leg bone. Okay. So children, let's quickly start with it. So if we see, this complete region, head region, is called skull. Kya bolte hum isko? Skull bolte hain. Clear? Come a bit lower. This is called collarbone. Kya bolte hum isko? Collarbone, or it is also called clavicle. Okay? Behind this, this is called shoulder bone. Isko hum kya bolenge? Shoulder bone. Okay? Now, this complete a cage-like structure is called rib cage. Kya bolte hai isko hum? Rib cage. Then this complete is a backbone and we call it as backbone or spine. Okay, or we also call it as vertebrae or vertebral column. Clear? Now this region, the hip region, is called pelvis. The bones present in hip region is called pelvis. Okay, then come to arms. In arms, this bone, the bone that is present here in the hand, is called humerus. It is called humerus. Then there are two bones present, one this side and one this side. So one is called radius and other is called ulna. What it is called? It is called radius and it is called ulna. Then we have bones of fingers. Okay, come to leg region. So this portion of leg is called femur. Then again we have two bones, like in arms, like in hand we have two bones. Similarly in legs also we have two bones. One is called fibula and another is called tibia. Okay, the thicker one is called fibula and the thinner one is called tibia. Okay, then we have the bones of feet. Okay, so this is the common structure of the human skeleton. Okay, sabse upper region is called skull. This is a skull. Then we have collarbone, jo ki yahan collar pe present hoti hai. Then we have a rib cage, which is present over our chest region. Then we have shoulder bone, that is present here at the shoulder region. Okay, in hands, coming to hand, this area, the upper hand region, is called humerus. Then we have two different bones, radius and ulna, just below the elbow. Elbow ke just niche jo ye region hota hai, there are two types of bone present. One is radius, another is ulna. Okay, then we have several finger bones. Okay, you can, children, just touch your hands, touch your hand, try to feel the bones that are present. Above your head, you have all the hard material that is a bone. Okay, so you will come to know about all these bones individually when we'll talk about all the parts individually. So this is human skeleton system. Okay, so we will see skull, ribcage, backbone and limbs in detail in this chapter. Okay, so let's quickly start with it. Let's start with skull. Children, just take your hand and try to touch your forehead. Try to touch your forehead, everybody. So what you are feeling, that there is something hard here, isn't it? Hard over your head, inside it. Everything is so hard. So that hard material is nothing but a bone. Okay? That hard material is nothing but a bone. Okay? So this complete facial bone, this complete brain region and this region of your face is included in skull. Isko hum kya bolte hain? Skull bolte hain. Clear? Now, this skull consists of 22 bones. Kitne bones hote hain skull mein? 22 bones hote hain. Theek hai? There are 14 bones present in our facial and we have few bones in our skull region, in the above head. Theek hai? Yahan pe bhi kuch bones hai, jo face pe bones present hai, they are called facial bones. जो आपके ये हेड रीजन जो कि ब्रेन को कवर कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पे बोन्स प्रेजेंट है, दे आर नॉर्मल बोन्स दैट वी कॉल इट. अब नाउ ट्राई टू फोकस, क्या हमारा यहाँ की बोन मूव करती है? हम क्या इसको मूव करा सकते हैं? नहीं, दे डज नॉट मूव. क्या यहाँ की बोन्स मूव करती है हेड रीजन की? नहीं, दे डोंट मूव. क्या ये बोन मूव कर रही है? आर दे मूविंग? No, they are also not moving. So what is moving? What is movable in your face? This jaw. Just try to do it. Yes, touch it and try to do it like this. So you will find that this jawbone, this is called jawbone, and only in the skull region, this jawbone is only movable. Iske alawa koi bhi bone move nahi karti hai. Only jawbone is movable in the skull. Clear? Okay. What does it do? Why it is important? So first of all, why it is important? Because brain is present inside it. Okay. So it is giving an outer hard covering to the brain. So brain is very important for our body, for to perform any work. Brain is very important. It plays a vital role in our body. Okay. तो उसको प्रोटेक्ट करना बहुत जरूरी है. उसको प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए वी हैव दिस स्कल रीजन. इवन टू प्रोटेक्ट द इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स ऑफ आर बॉडी, लाइक वी हैव ब्रेन, वी हैव लंग्स, वी हैव हार्ट. सो ऑल दीज थिंग विच आर वेरी क्रूशियल, वेरी सॉफ्ट, उनको प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए देयर आर बोन्स प्रेजेंट इन आर बॉडी. Okay, so what does bone do? First, bone provides a framework to the body. Second, it protects the internal organ. Okay, it protects the internal organ. Okay, so let's quickly see. So this is a skull. Can you see, children? This is a skull, all right? And for eyes, there are holes present. So you can see the holes for eyes, okay? You can also find several joints. Aap yahan pe joints dekh rahe ho? There are several joints. To aisa nahi hai ki skull sirf ek hota hai. Let's see here. Ye dekhiye. It is made up of several joints. So there are total 22 bones present in our skull. How many bones? 22 bones. Okay. So just have a look. There are 22 different bones present in our skull. So when they club together, they form a skull. Clear? Or his skull may only the jawbone. This jawbone is only movable. Nothing else is movable here. Only the jawbone is movable. Getting it? Getting it, children? So this is a skull region. Clear? What does this do? It protects the brain. It protects the brain, and it also has a facial bones. Okay? Facial bones jo face pe hoti hai, and then the brain bones that cover our body. Cover our brain. Okay? So this is a skull. Let's quickly see what is written in the chapter so that you can understand it better. So human skeleton system. The bones in your body make up the framework called skeleton. Okay. The skeleton of an adult human being is made up of 206 bones. A child has many more bones. It is approximately 300. Okay. As he grows, the few bones get fused together. Okay. Kabhi aap koi chota sa baby ho, to aap usko dekhna. Uske aap yahan pe skull pe touch karoge na, to it is very soft here. So I'll discuss about that later. Let's talk about functions of a skeleton. So first is support. So it gives a framework to the body, okay, and holds the body upright. Bones nahi honge, toh we cannot stand upright. Clear? So it supports the body. Then the second function is protection. So it protects the internal organ that are very soft, like brain, like lungs, like heart. So they protect them. Okay? Like heart, lungs. Okay, all these things are protected by bones. So it protects the internal organ. Movement. It helps in the movement of the body. See, we have several joints. Joints kya hote hain? Jahan pe do bones aake attach ho rahi hain, that point is called joints. Like if you see your finger, to aap fingers ko move kar rahe ho aise, to aap dekho ki ye bhi move kar raha hai and ye bhi move kar raha hai. So there are joints present here. Okay? Where two bones are attaching and there is a break in between. So that is called joint. Okay, and that joints helps in the movement. Clear? So joints are present in the skeleton and they help in the movement. Then making blood cells. Now this is important, children. See, bones are looking very hard. Bones bahut hard dikhti hain. But if you cut a bone and you will see, so bone is soft inside. Agar hum kisi bone ko cut kare, those who are non-vegetarian and have eaten the bone piece, you can easily see their children that inside the bone you have a soft tissue like structure and that is called bone marrow. That is called bone marrow, which is very soft and it helps in the development of blood cells. It helps in the development of blood cells. Clear? So bones also helps in the development of blood cells. Now coming on to the structure of human skeleton. So it is basically divided into four parts, that are skull, backbone or spine, ribs and limbs. So we have already discussed it. Skull kya hota hai? This area is called skull. Then you have a jawbone. This is called jawbone, that is movable. Then we have a collarbone. Okay. Then we have a breastbone, which is present in between the rib cage. It is also called sternum. Breastbone is also called sternum. Okay, we'll see to it. Then we have a shoulder blade or a shoulder bone. Then this cage-like structure is called a rib cage. Clear? Then we have this, a backbone. Okay? Now coming to the hand, this long is called humerus. Then you have radius and ulna. I have already told you. Then the bones of hand. Here you have a hip bone, which is present at your hip, is called pelvis. Then this long bone is called femur. In the center, jahan pe aapki knee hoti hai, wahan pe bone hota hai, that is called kneecap. Then we have fibula and we have tibia. Then there are bones of foot. Okay, so this is complete human skeleton and the bones of human skeleton. Okay, now we have to study individually what are they. So if we talk about a skull, so skull is a bony structure that surrounds and protects your brain. So skull protects our brain. It has hole for your eyes, ears, nose and mouth. So it has a hole. This skull is having hole for eyes, nose, ears and mouth. Okay. The upper part is made up of 8 flat bones. Ye jo aap upper part dekh rahe ho, 1, 2, 3, uske peeche 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 bones at the upper region. This upper region, it contains 8 bones. And the facial part consists of 14 bones. So altogether, it has 22 bones. Okay, altogether, the skull has 22 bones. Okay, among which only the lower jawbone is only movable bone in the skull, which enable us to talk and chew the food. और यहीं पे आपके teeth embedded होते हैं. Clear? So this is skull. Clear? Now let's move to the next part of the human skeleton, that is backbone or spine, or it is also called vertebrae or vertebral column. Children, this is the base of our body. ठीक है, अगर हमारी body upright है, अगर हमारी body straight है, तो it is because of this vertebrae only. Because of this vertebral column, only our body is upright. Getting it? Now, children, let's have a look very carefully. So, you can see there are several partitions. तो क्या होता है? ये block block में, in the form of block block, several bones are present as a stock. जैसे हम एक के ऊपर एक के ऊपर एक के ऊपर एक कोई चीज रख दें, इन द सेम पैटर्न दीज बोन्स आर अटैच्ड. नाउ हाउ यू कैन सी इट, व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, स्टैंड वेयर एवर यू आर सिटिंग, प्लीज स्टैंड अप. यस चिल्ड्रन, स्टैंड अप एट योर प्लेस. नाउ बेंड अ लिटिल, ट्राई टू टच योर फीट. Done. And from one hand, try to touch your back region in the center. Try to touch your back. From the neck till the back, till the hip in the center. So, can you find the small blocks like structure, a hard small block like structure? That is your backbone, okay? Or it is also called vertebrae or vertebral column. Clear? Or spine. ठीक है? इसको हम vertebrae, vertebral column या backbone बोलते हैं. There are altogether 33 bones present in the backbone. जो stocks में present है, एक के ऊपर एक रखी हुई है. There are 33 bones. Okay? It is not completely straight. It is a bit curved in structure. And because it is curved in structure, we are able to bend. We are able to go back. And we can twist and turn. Because this bone is a bit flexible. And this backbone is a bit flexible. And it is a bit curved in shape. So that we can twist and turn. We can bend properly. And we can do several activities. Okay, so that is why this bone is a bit curved bone. So as you can see here, okay, it is a bit curved. All right, and there are altogether, we have 33 bones, or they are also called, we have a 33 vertebrae. Clear? Now, between each bone that is present here is a small hole that contains the spinal cord. That contains the spinal cord, and this spinal cord is directly attached to the brain. This spinal cord is directly attached to the brain region. Getting it? And this vertebrae at the upper part is attached with the skull, and the lower region is attached with the hip bone or pelvis. Okay, so this makes a complete back structure, as you can see above here. तो क्या है, इस vertebral column का the upper part is attached with the skull, and the lower part is attached with this pelvis. Okay, so this makes the complete structure. And it also has a spinal cord that is directly connected to the brain. Okay, children. Then we have rib cage that we will see in the next class, that is tomorrow. Okay. So I hope it is clear to you. Skull is clear, backbone is clear. It has 33 small bones, which is called vertebrae. Helps in bending, twisting your back. It has a spinal cord. So children, please go through these chapter. You can easily understand it. It is written in a very easy language. You can easily understand it. Okay. Then we will talk about the rib cage and we'll see the limbs. Clear? Then after that, we'll talk about the joints and its movement. So I hope you are clear with this. So we have talked about the skull and we have talked about the backbone. And how they are important and how many bones are present there. Okay. So I hope children you are clear with all these two terms. Then we'll talk about ribcage and everything. So that's all for today's class. Thank you and Jai Hind children.